I'm Paul Wolf, and this is My City TV.
Talking about my city.
Welcome, Chef Enrika Williams, a return guest to My City TV. Chef, thanks for being here.
Thank you for having me again. It's great to be back here.
Now, we have return guests when folks have stuff going on, and you've got some stuff going on. We're going to talk about that a little later on in the program, but for folks who don't know Chef Enrika, she is the founder of Fauna Food Works. She was at Cultivation Food Hall as a vendor there for a while, and now private events and collaborating with other creatives here in town, the Magnolia Sunset Market, other chefs in town, James Beard House dinners, podcasts. You're all over the place these days.
Just a little bit, just trying to stay busy and creating.
Yeah, it's National Soul Food Month. The calendar reminded me of that the other day. And, you know, before you and I came on to talk here for the show, we talked about a very important documentary that's on Netflix right now called High on the Hog. Now, I've seen it, and it was powerful for me. I know you want to take some time to really immerse yourself in it, and I know it's going to be powerful for you, too.
Absolutely. A lot of the contributors to that project I know personally. And so for me, it's really intimate and it's really personal. And I want to give it like the undivided attention to be able to just take in everything, to process it, because it has been a journey to get to that point where Netflix had a beautiful project. I've heard beautiful things about it, so I don't expect anything less than stellar. From the experience.
That's fair. It deserves a thorough watch and a thorough appreciation. I told you before we came on that I don't think many in our white culture quite understand the contributions that African Americans, those who were enslaved and brought to this country, the contributions they've made on the food scene, the things that we still enjoy and eat today. There's a scene where they're eating fish in one of the villages in Africa there. And it wasn't catfish, which is our favorite here in Mississippi, but I love ketchup and catfish. And I didn't quite understand why. Mm-hmm. And apparently in Africa, fish and tomatoes are a huge thing. Yes. So it's just ingrained in us. And the food that we appreciate is the food that you now celebrate.
Absolutely. And another part of it too, I went to culinary school. And so usually in culinary school, the continent of Africa and its culinary traditions, even with the spice trade and the different ingredients that are indigenous to that area, are very broadly and loosely looked over, and they are not discussed. If you talk about Africa, it's always North African cuisine, and that's typically like, for whatever reason, they feel that Egypt and the Middle East that's the Middle Eastern culture, but Egypt is in Africa, and it's still considered African culture and food as well as Ghanaian and food from Sierra Leone and Ethiopian and Somalian. Like, there are all of these traditions there that you just have to kind of either meet someone from those areas and understand their traditions and put those pieces together, or you just do your own guerrilla research. And that's what happened with me in culinary school. I just refused to believe that the greatest culinary contributions just happened with escoffier in Europe, and that was the extent of culinary greatness. So it's just now, I think, what if nothing else, it's allowing people to do further research on their own and put those points together where they're understanding, I've always done this thing and never knew where it came from. And now that I know where it comes from, it's just like, well, why did it take me so long to put that together? Like, what was the disconnect in that? Because all other food traditions, any other culture, those traditions are revered and they are proudly boasted. And for some reason, you know, our traditions and the food are just kind of glazed over. And that's why I think unintentionally, but with intention, me being here in Jackson and being able to pull from some of that recall of my own childhood and the beautiful people that I met in my travels and going to school and living in other places. I just started figuring things out for myself.
Chef, I want to talk more about the ways that you're going to connect people later this month, Juneteenth celebrations, and your collaborations with others to bring that food to our bellies, to our hearts. We'll do that with Chef Enrika Williams right after this. Back with Chef Enrika Williams here on My City TV. Chef, let's just get right to it. You've got a really cool event happening next weekend, the 18th of June. It's a part of a Juneteenth weekend celebration that Magnolia Sunset Markets is helping to curate. Tell me about what you're doing out at Footprint Farms on Friday, the 18th. This sounds really exciting.
Absolutely. So, Fauna Food Works, we are putting on a dinner to celebrate Juneteenth in a way that that spotlights juke joints. More specifically, I'm from West Point, Mississippi. I was born and raised there. So more specifically, the actual description is meet me at Babs Boogie Box. So I just thought that was a cool name for a juke joint. It's a made up name, but it will be hosted at, it will be hosted at Footprint Farms. And basically what we're doing is we are talking about moonshine, high-end juke joint revelry, and nightlife celebrating Juneteenth and the culture of the mystical backwoods of 1939 Northeast Mississippi. And what we're doing there is we are asking for there is a dress code. So we want people to interpret what the vibe or the feeling is from like the mid-30s to late 40s. There will be juke joint food. Those of us who know, there will be definitely some sort of smoked meat. We're going to have fried fish and spaghetti. There will be all of the things that one would find at a juke joint deep in the woods. There is going to be red punch there that I'm going to make with hibiscus. It may or may not be spiked with a little bit of moonshine. And we're definitely going to have the blues there. I feel that there is some sort of mysticism about the backwoods of Mississippi, especially with the music and the food and the people. And we have just been through so much in these last few months, years. And I wanted a place for people to celebrate and dance and be jubilant and drink and eat. And so we're just recreating that. We're going to actually turn the wind tunnel at the Footprint Farms into a juke joint. So it will be encouraged to dance and wear dancing shoes. And we're just going to have a good time. We're excited about it. It's going to be fun. But the attention to the detail and the sincerity in what we're doing, we know is going to be felt. And we just want people to come out and celebrate that with us. And have a good time and eat.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Hey, I want to ask you quickly, there's another collaboration that you have that mm-hmm. weekend with Chef Roshana Newsom. And right there where you're sitting, there at Eco Shed in mm-hmm. the Industry Park neighborhood of Jackson. Just briefly tell me, she's doing a brunch, right?
Yes. So part of our weekend to close out the Juneteenth weekend, we are the Flamingo Jackson, which is an amazing, beautiful boutique here inside of the Eco Shed, is hosting us, and we're going to do a brunch. And Roshana is coming up with the menu. She's curating the menu. And I'm going to be sous chef to her chef to help her out. This will be her debut into doing something, a project of her own. And we're super excited to work with fellow creatives and have platforms and the ticket as well. The links are on social media and on the website. And we would love for people to come out and just support her and encourage her in her culinary endeavors. So, because that's what the market and what Fauna is about. That's what we love to do and we strive to do, is to connect those creative spaces together and collaborate. That's what gives us the eagerness to do this.
So much fun and so much energy happening right now in Jackson, Mississippi. Absolutely. I know I've asked you this question before, but again, the answer is always bear repeating. Why do you do what you do? Why do you want to make Jackson a better place?
Jackson is a better place. I think a lot of times people fixate themselves on a thing and they just want to see it in that way. I can only go by my personal experience and my personal encounters and what I've been afforded the opportunity. And I just want to share in that Jackson is full of brilliance. It's full of brilliant people. They're full of people who are making changes, who are doing things, and they're doing them beautifully. And I'm just honored to be a part of that. And anytime I'm in a space where I can expound on that and work with other people, I'm going to do that. So it's, I don't have to go far to find what's always here. And I just want people on a bigger scale to see that. We have an amazing voice and amazing gifts right here.
And I think I can fairly say that those of us in the creative field here in the City of Seoul who are constantly trying to get that message out, we can just all call ourselves storytellers, be it through our writing or our food or our music or whatever we do. And I'm glad that you, chef and storyteller, Enrika Williams, called Jackson, Mississippi home. Thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you for having me again, Paul. Thanks so much.
That's the show. Check us out at jxn.ms and join us for another episode of My City TV.